I sang that song for more than 60 years, a song of praise to Joseph Smith, the prophet of the Restoration and founder of the LDS Church, the church I served as a bishop for 5 years. I knew the church was true. I was a faithful Latter-day Saint.
My life has been built on certain truths, but wishing doesn't change the truth.
Jesus said, "You shall know the truth, and the truth will make you free." When I finally learned the truth about the real history and doctrines of Mormonism, I realized that I was following the gospel of Joseph Smith and not the gospel of Jesus Christ. I have come to learn that many others have made a similar journey out of the bondage of religion and into an authentic relationship with Jesus. And that's what this show is all about. Courageous people who want to share their story, hoping that you, the viewer, will discover the same new life in Jesus. So if you're a Latter-day Saint who is struggling with questions or seeking a genuine encounter with the Savior, we invite you to join us tonight. We have a joyful message that we want to share with you. Good evening and welcome to the Ex-Mormon Files here in the heart of Salt Lake City. I'm your host, Bishop Earl, and appreciate you spending some of your evening with us. I have an interesting guest tonight, Judy Lucas, and I think that your story will relate to a lot of people who are in the church and who have had family members who have experienced different things in the church, so appreciate you coming and sharing your story.
Okay.
Tell us a little bit about your born in the covenant, I guess.
Yes, you? I was. I was born under the covenant. My parents weren't real active when I was growing up. Yeah. I always went to church, but I don't remember them being active until it was about the time I got married that they became real active.
Oh, and so they just sent you off to church?
Yes, or? Yes, yeah. Yes. But,
So you mean the youth programs and primary?
Primary and Sunday school and mutual and, you know, all of those things.
Yeah.
And they used to have those dances back then, and I would go to all of those and the movies and different things like that. I was involved in it.
Yeah. Did you ever question that the church wasn't true? Did you just assume that this was your life?
And well, this was, I didn't know any true? Different. That's what I was taught.
Isn't that interesting?
That's what I grew up with. Yeah. I had no idea.
And we don't really learn the positives or the negatives in some regards, do we?
No.
We just kind of go through the motions.
And, right.
Yeah.
And then I had met a girl at work, and I thought, she has something that I don't have. And she asked me to study the Bible.
How old were you at this point?
Oh, I was in my 50s.
Oh, okay. We've jumped up ahead then.
Yeah, a little bit.
Well, were you you were active kind of in
off and on, off and on. Somebody had hurt my feelings and I'd leave the church, you know.
Really?
Yeah.
So you were one of those. I haven't run into too many that have actually had their feeling, or they were offended.
I was offended several times.
Oh.
And I just thought, okay, I don't want anything to do with this, so I'd go away, and then
I didn't
mean
the church wasn't true, you just...
I just...
Kind of...
Yeah, I wanted to go do my own thing. I went inactive.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Mm-hmm. But you do eventually get married in the temple.
I did. When my daughter got married in 1983, we went, took out our endowments, and we had the kids seal to us.
Oh, okay.
And then we all went through the temple when they got married.
Oh.
So I went through the temple in 83.
What was that experience like for you?
It was different. I didn't understand what was going on. And I went back a few times, and I just thought, these oaths and things are really strange. And
why didn't I see that?
I don't know. The temple itself was beautiful.
Sure. Yeah.
And, you know, all of that, but...
Your spirit, something was telling
something
you
something wasn't, you know, quite right. I didn't say anything to anyone.
No.
But I thought, why are they giving these horrible oaths? God wouldn't require that,
I don't think.
This
was back in 83.
That was back in 83, as before I got...
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah, that was back. And I thought, well, if the church is true, why are they keep changing their belief system?
Yeah.
Their why do they change that temple ceremony? Why do they keep changing? They're like a chameleon. And
yeah, they have done a number of changes over the years. I think it's to become more acceptable to the public or to the general membership or something, and it does seem odd that God would have things change. I know I thought that was strange, but I put that on a shelf.
Yeah, you do. You
just how many children did you have?
I had 3 children.
Yeah, and they were all active in the church? And
My 2 daughters are. My son, he's like the prodigal son.
One of those, huh?
One of those, yeah.
Okay.
He believes like I do,
yeah,
but he doesn't have the lifestyle.
So then shortly after this, then this friend challenges you to read
this
the Bible.
This was in 94.
Now, that didn't seem like a strange request to a Mormon, because you believe in the Bible.
I believe in the Bible.
At least as far as it's translated correctly.
And that was what the problem was. They make you leery of reading the Bible because of that statement. You automatically don't trust it.
I know it.
And so I said, okay, I don't know anything about that Bible. I'll have Bible study with you. Well,
so you went to a Bible study with
I went. One-on-one to her home, and I bombarded her with questions. She didn't have the answers either, so she had to go to the pastor and then relay them to me.
Wow.
And when I first started, it looked like it paralleled pretty close of what I was taught.
In Mormonism.
In Mormonism. Yeah. And then all of a sudden, it wasn't what I was taught.
No.
It was a different God. A different Jesus, a different gospel.
Yeah, the grace, the gospel.
And the grace,
of grace.
Nothing matched up. And I remember asking God, I didn't really want to leave the church because I was comfortable. That's a long time to be in the church.
Well, it's your life, your family.
And my family and everything.
And by then you'd mentioned that your folks became even more active.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And so I was going to prove her wrong.
Uh-oh.
And so I started studying the Mormon church. I got some books from Sandra Tanner.
Okay.
And I started reading those, and then I compared them with the Book of Mormon.
Yeah.
And when I started reading that, I thought, goodness, they don't line up.
No.
They'll say one thing in the Book of Mormon, get over the Doctrine and Covenants, and it says something totally different.
Yeah.
So which is it?
Did you begin to start trusting the Bible? Did you start seeing some proof texts for that?
I did. I started in the Gospel of John.
Yeah.
And I started reading, and I couldn't wait to get home from work to read the Bible. I felt like it was God speaking to me through His Word.
Had you ever experienced that
before? I'd never experienced that before, ever in my life.
Well, we didn't trust the Bible.
Yeah. And I remember praying to God, and I says, I want the truth. No matter which way it leads me, I want the truth. God is patient, and He kept showing me scripture after scripture after scripture. He was putting it together like a puzzle. And then it got
just
to the...
Just helping you right along the way, huh?
Then it got to the point where I had to make a decision. Okay, this is the way it is. What are you going to do?
Wow.
That's when I had to make a decision. And, you know, I kept praying, and I asked God, is Joseph Smith really a true prophet?
Yeah.
And I kept praying because I wanted to know. I came home from work one day and opened my Bible, Hebrews 1:1, God who at sundry times on divers manners spoke to us by His prophets, in these latter days has spoken to us by His Son, Jesus Christ. There's my answer.
Wasn't that powerful?
That was powerful. That was God that showed me. Nobody showed me that. God showed me that.
You'd probably never even thought of that or read that scripture before.
I didn't.
It's amazing how it opens up.
It just,
you're looking, you're willing to look.
Look, because He will take you as quick or as slow as you want to go, as deep or as shallow as you want to go.
So you kept going to this Bible study, learning more and more.
Learning more and more.
Yeah.
I decided to go 1 week to the Christian church and 1 week to the Mormon church.
Okay.
And I was very, very critical of both churches.
Trying to really assess
what am I seeing here? And so I went to the Mormon church, and I was sitting there in Relief Society, and they were talking about the game, and they were talking about frizzial things, not anything to do with the gospel. They were talking about things they did the night before and different...
Yeah, it's funny how they don't really talk about Jesus.
No.
I mean, he's there. We pray in his name.
Right.
And the sacrament and stuff. Yeah. But, yeah, just not a lot.
But then I went to the Christian church, and all they talked about was Jesus. They exalted Jesus. And that was an experience in itself, going to a Christian church from a Mormon church.
Yeah. What did you think of that?
I thought they were all crazy. But I kept going.
But praising Jesus.
Mm-hmm, but everything was focused on Jesus.
Yeah.
And they read the Bible. Yeah. They didn't have other books.
Isn't that amazing?
Mm-hmm.
And so you kept going. And
so I kept going.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Wow. Now, did you eventually share this with your father's a temple?
Yes,
worker,
yes.
And
I did.
Did you finally share this with him?
I did. I talked to both my father and my mother.
Yeah.
My father was more receptive to it.
Yeah.
And he said, I don't know what you have, but don't let any man take it from you. I'll probably not change, but don't you change either.
Oh,
so
that was sweet of him.
Whatever he saw in me, my mother totally, totally rejected it. She got mad and she said a few not kind words and left. And I thought, okay. Well, what happened, we went down to my sister who lived in Colorado. And they were going to go to church that day. Well, my mother pitched a fit. She had Alzheimer's. Mm. She wasn't going to go to church. And, of course, I wasn't going to go.
Yeah.
So I stayed there. Dad says, can Mom stay here with you? And I says, sure. Yeah. So we sat there and watched. I remember the preacher. It was Ronnie Floyd. And I looked at my mother and I said, Mom, are you afraid of dying? She shook her head, yes.
Isn't that sad?
And I says, Mom, you don't need to.
Yeah.
I says, Christ died for you. You don't need to be scared. You can go to heaven. I says, I know you can't talk, but let me pray a prayer with you. So I prayed a prayer with her.
Oh.
And just after I got through praying it, Ronnie Floyd prayed almost the same prayer that I had prayed. It was a sinner's prayer.
Yeah.
And she accepted and she just nodded her head yes, and the tears just started flowing down her face.
Did it really?
Yes. So I know she was saved.
Wow.
And I didn't tell my dad for quite a while.
Yeah.
But then I finally did tell him. He said I didn't know that. But I knew the persecution I went through. I didn't want my mother to go through that.
Yeah. Well, did you, you were married at this time when you were going to the Christian Bible study? Was
yes.
your husband a member?
He was not active.
Oh, okay. Was he receptive? Did he?
Oh, no. He defended the Mormon church.
Isn't that funny, where he
mm-hmm.
doesn't really go
no.
and inactive?
Mm-hmm. And he'd watch the Christian church, and then he'd watch things that the Mormons had. And he'd ask me questions. Well, where is this in the Bible? What does the Bible say about this? He was witnessing to his friends. I didn't know that. And, you know, I kept asking him to go to church with me, and he wouldn't do it. And he said, I don't need to go to church. I've got a preacher that sits across the table. Okay.
That was you, I guess.
So, anyway, I kept praying and asked God, please save his soul. Save his soul and bring him to church with me. He got cancer. He got sick.
Mm-hmm.
And God granted both of those. He brought him to church one time, and he saved his soul.
Oh, good.
But that was God that did that.
Yeah.
It took about 7 years. It wasn't easy.
Yeah.
And I would go to church by myself, and I would invite him to go,
yeah.
but he refused, and I said, okay, I'm going. I'll see you in a while.
You went to a play. Was this after this time?
That was when I got saved. I went to Master Mender's.
I'd never heard of that.
It's a play that the Assembly of God over there on Bangor and about 47th South, they put it on. They used to put it on every year.
Oh.
And it's a reenactment of the life of Jesus.
Oh.
And they even have a donkey that goes down like the triumphal entry.
Right.
And I got saved that night, but I didn't understand what had happened to me.
What do you mean?
I felt different. It was the day before Easter, And my family were over to the house. And my two son-in-laws are returned missionaries. And they wanted me to read the Book of Mormon.
They knew you were going to this Christian Bible study?
They knew that I had left the church because I had announced that I had left the Mormon church.
Okay.
And so they knew I was going to the
Christian.
They
wanted you to read the Book of Mormon, pray about it, I guess.
And I said, as soon as they brought that Book of Mormon on the table, my spirit just, I didn't want anything to do with that.
Wow.
I don't know what it was.
The spirit saying.
Yeah. I said, I'll study the Bible with you, but not the Book of Mormon. So my son-in-law said, the next morning was conference. It was Easter Sunday. It was conference. Will you listen to conference? I said, okay, I'll do that.
And this was after the Master Mender?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
That was the next day. I went to Master Mender on Saturday night, and this happened Sunday morning.
Okay.
And so I said, okay. So I listened to conference, and I was there all by myself. And it was just like God dropped me right down on my knees. And they were reading in Isaiah. I can't tell you where it was because I don't remember. But I thought, okay, it's the Mormon church. I guess I'm going to go back to the Mormon church. And so...
You're feeling the spirit. This must be true or something.
Yeah. So I talked to my girlfriend and I says, I'm going back into the Mormon church.
Wow.
And she said, because I was watching conference and I thought it was the Mormon church. And she said, where were they reading? And I said, they were reading in Isaiah. She said, that's the Bible.
Yes.
And so I said, okay, then I'm going to stay with the Christian church. Yeah. So I did. And it was quite an experience. I've had a lot of different experiences that, and I have had more obstacles than I ever had in the Mormon church.
Well, we do have to think a little bit as Christians,
yeah.
Don't we?
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, things aren't just handed to us.
No.
We have to search.
No, you
look.
Have to study and you have to search.
Yeah.
And, you know, there was a scripture that really bothered me. And it said, let the dead bury the dead. And I thought, what in the world is he talking about?
Yeah.
And I struggled with that scripture for a long time. And then it hit me. When we're born sinners. Because of the fall of Adam and Eve.
Right.
And so we're spiritually dead until we become born again. Then our spirit is brought to life.
Yeah.
And if you're not born again, you can't...
And the LDS don't understand that mm-hmm. because they think being born again is just being baptized receiving the Holy Ghost.
No, that has nothing to do with it. Why did Christ have to die and suffer like he did on the cross if we could add anything to our salvation? When mm-hmm. he was on the cross, he said, it is finished. He paid for it because he was sinless. He said, it is finished. It's a gift.
Another thing that Mormons don't understand, right?
No.
Yeah. I always thought that I had to do my little checklist and I'd move up the ladder
mm-hmm.
down the ladder
mm-hmm.
and I'd try to do my best and
it wasn't good enough, was it?
And it never is good enough. It's impossible.
Right. I felt like I was never good enough in the Mormon church. I felt short of everybody else.
Yeah.
And when God showed I thought, well, I'll make it to heaven somewhere. I'll probably make it in the lowest kingdom, but that's okay.
Joseph Smith said we'd kill to be in the lowest kingdom anyway, so we figured that's probably okay.
But God showed me that I was a sinner, and I needed him. And without him, I would not make it anywhere.
Yeah.
And that was an eye-opener for me, because I thought, you know, I'm a pretty good person. I don't, you know, do a lot of things that other people have done.
Yeah.
But I was still a sinner.
Yeah. As they say, good people don't go to heaven, but saved people do.
Right, exactly.
Those that are born again.
Exactly.
Well, you've had such an interesting experience. Now you just can't get enough of the Bible, right?
That's right. That's right. Yeah. And it's been... He doesn't show you this all at once.
No.
It's a process.
Yeah.
And I've had to change churches. And
sure. But you have the freedom to search and
to search and do that.
And family, where are they at?
I have two daughters that are very active in the Mormon Church.
And are you able to visit with them, share with them at all?
I can't share with them. I can visit with them, but...
But not about religion?
They're not, no, they're not interested in anything I have to say.
Yeah. It has always struck me, I can spend hours with some of my family and never talk about Jesus.
Right.
And it just drives me nuts.
Uh-huh.
Does it do you that
yes,
same thing?
Yes. And if I have...
And yet, excuse me, as a Latter-day Saint, that wouldn't have bothered me at all.
No, it wouldn't
have. I could have gone weeks, you know, not talking
right.
about Jesus or anything. Now, I just want to... That's what I want to talk about.
That's your whole life.
Yeah.
That's who you are.
Yeah.
That's your whole life.
What's the difference, do you think? And what are they missing?
The Spirit of God.
I guess so, huh?
The Spirit of God.
Well, they're praising the man, they're worshiping...
They're worshiping...
They're giving everything to the organization, the
right.
church.
They're not bringing people to Christ. They're bringing people to the church.
That's right.
And in the Christian church, believers are the church. We are the temple of the Holy Spirit.
Yeah, another thing that they don't understand
Mm-mm.
is that the temple and...
No. And that's another thing. The temples, back in the Old Testament, they were used for sacrifice.
Yeah, the shedding of blood.
The shedding of blood. And that priest had to go into the Holy of Holies once a year to atone for the sins. And it didn't take away the sins, it just covered them for a year.
And then when Jesus came, it just took care of
it. He wiped them clean. He paid the ultimate price.
And the veil of the temple was
rent. And the veil of the temple was rent from top to bottom. There's no more temple. There will be another temple during the tribulation, and I believe there'll be a millennial temple.
Yeah, perhaps. Anyway, it's just such a glorious message now, and
it
just
is.
Didn't appreciate that as a Mormon,
it
I'm
is.
Sure.
But that's all I want to talk about.
Yeah.
That's all.
Do you think there are people out there like you, like me, that have gone through some of this experience? They're not quite there yet, but they're struggling with
different
things.
They're struggling with it. I think a lot of them, they won't leave because their jobs are tied in with it. Their family, their wives, or their husbands will divorce
yeah.
them. That's
very stressful.
That's the
it?
Chance you take.
Yeah.
And but God is faithful.
Yeah.
And you just have to trust Him.
Well, and knowing that we're going to have to stand before Him one
right.
day without anybody.
Without
else.
Anybody.
Yeah. Not going to have the church standing there
no,
with you.
No. What did you do with Jesus?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and to not understand that. Any scriptures that you had come across, that you mentioned the one in Isaiah, do you think that was the 9-6, Isaiah 9-6?
It might have been, I don't know.
For unto us a child is born?
It might have been, I don't know what it was.
One it was.
It probably was because it was Easter Sunday, so that would be a resurrection message.
Yeah, that could be.
So it could have been that one, but I was so new, I didn't know.
Yeah.
I didn't know the Bible, but... That one scripture, for by grace you are saved through faith and not of yourself. It's a gift of God. You don't pay for
Lest
a gift.
Lest any man
should
boast.
Right.
Yeah.
Right.
And that's just what we did in Mormonism,
mm-hmm.
I felt, is so
there was
proud
a lot
of
pride.
Ourselves.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And
mm-hmm.
judgment.
And judgment.
Yeah.
I was very judgmental.
Yeah.
Very
well,
judgmental.
Well, if anybody doesn't quite meet the standard
mm-hmm.
or aren't keeping the commandments, you judge them.
Right.
Yeah.
Right. But it's not like that. You come just as you are. I bet if Christ walked into one of those churches, they wouldn't accept Him because of the way He'd be dressed.
Yeah, that's for sure. I've thought about a few of those little things. Where would Jesus come to?
Yeah.
You know, would He come to the conference center, or would He be coming to the poor?
No, because yeah. look where He went to.
Yeah.
He went to the poor class.
Well, we've got just a minute or two left. What would you say to the Latter-day Saints?
I would say, don't take any man's word for anything. Check it out for yourself and make sure it's biblically sound.
And do they don't even need to go to what you'd call anti-Mormon material,
no.
do
no.
they?
No, they can go in their own scriptures and see where it contradicts.
Yeah. Well, and I the big surprise to me, and I don't know how you miss this as a Mormon, is the Book of Mormon itself. It contains very little of what we'd call Mormon doctrine.
Exactly.
I mean, there's no 3 degrees of glory.
No.
There's no baptism for the dead.
No. And the Book of Mormon says there's one God, which lines up with the Bible.
Yeah.
And the Doctrine and Covenant said there's many gods.
Well, I think I think Joseph Smith wrote that Book of Mormon before he changed his mind about a lot of things. I think he was more of a Christian
right.
person at that point, mm-hmm. and he had all these...
But he's plagiarized the Bible because he's almost taken them word for word.
Makes sense. Including the King James errors.
Yes.
Which is a whole nother story.
That's right.
Have you been, now you've been out, so to speak, for how long?
I've been out for 20 years.
Okay, so you've seen some of the changes that have occurred over the last many years, the TV programs, mm-hmm. and radio. Has that been encouraging to you to see the,
yes,
maybe the more interest in what Mormons are really teaching?
Exactly, yeah. Yes, yeah.
You've been watching?
I watch Doris Hansen all the time because, you know, part of my family was in that.
In polygamy.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, mm-hmm. And so, and I just love what she does at the very end when she summarizes things and,
yes.
and shares such a powerful message.
Yes.
And you think people are listening to that, paying attention?
I would hope they are.
Yeah.
But it's going to take the Holy Spirit. It really is.
It really is in God's timing, isn't
yeah,
it?
And like in John chapter 3, unless you're born again, you will not see the kingdom of God.
Well, I'm impressed that you would feel that spirit, not really knowing what it was you were experiencing.
No, I did not know. I was too new in it. I didn't know what it was.
Yeah.
But I felt the effects of it.
Yeah. And to feel the spirit of conference and the Book of Mormon and things.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I hope the LDS will pay attention.
I do too.
Study.
I do too, because
we
I
do
love,
care about.
I do. I yeah. love the Mormon people. They're good people.
Yeah.
But I do not like their doctrine.
Well, it is Mormonism, and like's been said here before, we think the leaders know more than they probably are letting on. I know they don't say much at conference time. They kind of give fluffy talks. They mm-hmm. don't really talk much doctrine. I always attributed that to the fact that we were that they were trying to cater to the new members of the church
mm-hmm.
and were trying to overwhelm them with heavy-duty doctrine. But I think now it's just that I don't know that they even believe the heavy doctrine of the church anymore.
Do you think they really know, or do you think they're deceived also?
Well, they're deceived, but they've had enough people come out of the church that have shared this information with them. They must know. Anyway, Judy, thanks so much. Our time's gone.
Oh, wow. That was fast.
I appreciate you. Yeah. Appreciate you sharing your story. And remember, you are following the gospel of Joseph Smith and not the gospel of Jesus Christ. Good night.